Having been tracking the construction industry for almost 40 years, Glenigan knows the building cycle inside out. Our vast reach sees us capture every UK planning application and decision, whilst providing extensive construction activity analysis and forecasting. Let's show you just how the cycle unfolds. We're going to look at a typical £10 million contract. It all starts with the client needing a building and appointing legal and financial advisors. The professional construction consultant team is then appointed to advise on the project and steer the procurement process. The professional construction consultant team typically consists of an architect, a structural consultant, a building services consultant, and a cost consultant. The team provide the client with project management and procurement services, drawing up the designs for submission to the local planning authority, while also establishing bills of quantities based on these detailed designs. The local planning authority grants the outline planning and sets up local consultation and planning committee meetings to get wholesale approval. Having received approval from the local planning authority, the process of inviting preferred contractors to tender can begin. The opportunity to tender is open. For contractors interested in tendering for the project, a pre-qualification questionnaire is completed and submitted, and from all the bidders, six are selected to tender. The shortlisted contractors submit tenders, and two are selected for further negotiations to decide which contractor will be appointed. Glenigan tracks every stage of the planning and contracting process, notifying our clients when contract tenders have been invited and bids are required for submission. We identify bidders through our research and our exclusive partnership with the Builders' Conference and monitor projects to identify the successfully appointed main contractor. The local authority gives planning consent and returns to the planning committee to present the final submissions. The appointed main contractor then invites Tier 2 package contractors to bid for specialist elements of the project, such as foundations, structural concrete and steel work, glazing, building services, roofing and fit-out packages. The main contractor then appoints Tier 2 firms. Our continual tracking of projects means Glenigan clients can access details of key people in these specialist contractors. Next, the main contractor works with the Tier 2 firms to complete the health and safety assessments and negotiate on the final pricing, delivery and designs before signing the Stage 2 agreement. The designs are returned to the main contractor for refinement and the Tier 2 firms begin selecting the Tier 3 contractors responsible for brickwork, roofing, scaffolding, electrical and mechanical works, dry lining and finishing works. The designs are finalised by the main contractor and supply agreements are drafted up between all builders, merchants and manufacturers. The time has come to prepare for construction, with site teams mobilised and recruited, labour subcontractors brought on board and construction equipment hired. As more specialist contractors, materials and service providers are required, Glenigan equips its clients with timely project and people information to secure new business. As site security and preliminary works are completed and work starts on site, the Glenigan Index tracks this, thus serving as a forward indicator of industry activity. The site manager becomes responsible for the running of the programme, the site, the coordinating of subcontractors, and the safety of the working environment. The building is carefully completed, and claims can now be placed for Tier 2, completion, and main contractor milestones. The client's quantity survey then completes an assessment of the work to verify that the project has been completed to the appropriate standard. If work completed is unsatisfactory, payment is disputed and a court of adjudication or arbitration opened for the contractor in question. At various stages of the process, local authority officers and building control inspectors will visit to ensure certain areas comply with regulations. Once the building has been certified compliant by authorities, the client engineer will sign the completion certificate. As part of this, any work still required, such as the refurbishment of minor defects, will be scheduled. Snagging will subsequently take place to ensure such minor defects are addressed and the project reaches completion. The client settles the outstanding final payment with the main contractor, and the property is handed over officially to the client. At this stage, the main contractor can issue retention payments to the second tier contractors, having kept this to ensure the work was completed successfully. Glenigan tracks projects to completion on site to provide the complete picture. The building occupier now facilitates a secondary fitting to meet their requirements. A warranty period is also established to cover the cost of any repairs, and a management contract is also put in place to ensure the ongoing upkeep and maintenance of the building. As well as tracking new builds and refurbishments, Glenigan also identifies companies moving premises. And that's the building cycle.